ABC, it's Ron. Thanks for dropping by for part three of my continuing series on 45 RPM company sleeves. Got a pretty good pile lined up today. Nice fat stack, and it's pretty much going to be all 60s. And on Record Store Day, I even got a nice pile of 45s with some vintage company sleeves with those. And they were all 50 cents a piece, so I was able to do some swapping on the sleeves. So I got the sleeves I wanted with the records that I wanted. So it worked out great. They didn't care, so why not, right? So let's get going on the next portion of the video. Okay, VC, let's get going with these 45s. Start off with a little Marty Balin. This is the same Marty Balin that was in the Jefferson Airplane, and this is an early record from him. It's his second 45 from July of 62, and Challenge Company Sleeve. Here's a cool one on Date, The Distant Cousins, kind of a garage rocker. And it is from June of 66. Here's a classic sleeve on Hanna-Barbera, The Five Americans, I See the Light. November 1965. Here's a budget label that featured top 10 hits. And they had unknown bands doing cover versions. I'm sure you've seen that record around before, but how many times have you seen that company sleeve? It's got 19th Nervous Breakdown, A Daydream, and it's from 1966. Here's a cool company sleeve that I just picked up on Record Store Day. And I flipped when I found this because these are hard to find. And the record is The Beatles' Love Me Do from October of 1964. This is actually was made by VJ Records. Here's Elfstone, Louisiana Teardrops, and it's a Kim Fowley, Michael Lloyd involvement on this one. And this is their only record from April 1969. Cool garagey pop record. Pretty cool. Here's a Dunhill. And this is the original Grassroots, the original version of the band. And April of 1966. Nice folk rock here. And a non-album tune from their first album. Here's the Choir, and they had the hit It's Cold Outside, and this is another record from them. And some of the members went on to form the Raspberries, and this one's from August of 67. There's two different versions of this company sleeve. The earlier version has a gray dot, while this one has the blue. Here's the Hamilton Streetcar on Dot. Now this band had some 45s on Lee Hazelwood's label. But this is a later one from them from July of 69. Here's the Minettes of England on DCP. And I think this is their only record. It's very much like Dave Clark 5. Upbeat rocker from January of 1965. Pretty obscure label here, and I'm sure that company sleeve is even more obscure. Here's Wand and the second pressing of the Kingsman Louie Louie. And this is from October of 63. You can always tell the earlier one sleeves, it'll say have the Broadway address down here at the bottom. whereas later on they would have a different address. Here's White Whale and the Turtles, and this is actually their first 45, It Ain't Me Babe, from July of 65, and it's got the great garage rocker B-side, Almost There. Here's a classic Uni Company sleeve, and the band is The Rainy Days. And they had one album, but this track here, Blood from Oblivion, is that's not on that album. And that's Cool Psych. And this is from July of 67. Here's an Imperial sleeve with the moon. And this is February of 1968. Here's a Call Gems, The Monkees. And this one is from 22668. And it just dawned on me that I think Cold Gems ripped off Columbia on their company sleeve. I mean, that's the exact design layout as the gray Columbia sleeves from the 60s. So, little ripoff going on there, I think. Still a cool sleeve. Here's Things to Come, and this is their third 45 and their last one. And this one was produced by David Crosby. Nice Warner Brothers company sleeve there, and it's September of 1968. Here's Jimi Hendrix, Freedom, and this is from his Cry of Love album. It's from 3/18/71. Nice Warner reprise connection going on here. You see the company sleeves are very similar in style to one another. It's because these two labels were in cahoots with each other. Okay, now I'm going to show some variants in the same sleeve. And this is Tower. And this is the first version. It has the R and a circle for registered. And this one is from December of 1965. And then the second version, it's more of a glossy sleeve, and they remove the circled R. This is October of 66. And then the third variation, and the last for this particular design, is this one, and it has a red strip at the base of the sleeve. No circled R. And this is from February of 68. This is a promo of the Standells' last record, non-album tracks, and I really like Animal Girl a lot. Okay, here's a subsidiary of Buddha Records, Team, and this is their company sleeve that the record came out in from September of 68. And here's another Buddha subsidiary, Super K, Question Mark and the Mysterians, Hang In, which is a really cool instrumental. And this is actually the A-side, Sha La La, but the B-side's better. And it's from January of 69. And you can see some differences between this sleeve and this sleeve. A little bit different color variations going on there. Okay, here is Tok Tok in the original Boring, original sound company sleeve. And this one is from 7 of 66. And then you've probably seen this one around. It's a bit hard to find, but I've showed it before. And this one actually came out later, way later than this one. Oldies But Goodies Volume 7. So that was the current volume that was out at the time of this record came out. And this one on the back features volume 9. So this is a little bit later. And I'm not exactly sure what record came in this particular sleeve, or maybe a few different ones did. But I have a promo of The Eagle Never Hunts the Fly from June of 67. And that's actually a hole, and that's the backing board. Okay, I'm going to show some Bell subsidiaries. We've got Mala, and the band is Adam, which is Early Balloon Farm, which is just killer. November of 66. And then Amy, early one by the Guess Who. It's My Pride, which is actually the B-side of His Girl from February of 67. This is really good. It's got this killer lead bass break in it. Bass guitar, really cool. And the third one I want to show is actually the Bell label, and this is Crazy Elephant, Dark Part of My Mind. And it's from March of 69. Okay. Three different records and three different variations. Lighter blue, and then a little bit darker blue, and then the final version is gray. Okay, now I'll show some Electra sleeves, and this is a hard to find first version Electra Company sleeve. And this is People Are Strange, and this is a white based version from Specialty Records, which is still first pressing. And this is pressed on real vinyl, which is good. And it's from September of 67. And then we got another, and this is a second company sleeve. The Doors, You Make Me Real, in dedicated mono. I mean, it's a separate mono mix from the stereo mix. And on this version, at the beginning of the record, you can hear Jim say, "Come on." You listen to the song in stereo, and you won't be able to hear him say that. And the flip is Roadhouse Blues. It's also in mono, and it's from March of 1970. Pretty unusual that that is in mono. Okay, this is the next company sleeve for Electra, Riders on the Storm, and it has the address down at the bottom there. And this sleeve was in use for maybe, I don't know, year and a half, something like that, who knows. And this is June of 71. And that's glossy paper, by the way. And then the next variation came out several months later, and it's got the large Electra logo, and this is from November of 1971. Okay, here's some Atcos, and Atcos have been to get, they've had the same design forever. They, for some reason, I mean, from the 50s all the way up through the late 70s, they never changed their designs. The real early Atco company sleeves will not have any address at the base. And then I figure around 66 or 67, they added the Atlantic address. And this particular record is from December of 66. And then a couple years later, they changed the company sleeve again. And instead of manufactured by Atlantic, it says manufactured by Atco. And this is an Iron Butterfly 45 from September of 1969. This would be their last record to feature the classic Iron Butterfly sound. After this, they did the Metamorphosis thing. So this is still the original lineup, and these are non-album tracks. Pretty cool, and definitely worth having. All right, show some RCA Victor. This is a white label promo of the first Jefferson Airplane 45 from February of 66. It's no secret. And the cool thing about it is it's got Running Around This World on the B-side, which was originally on the very earliest version of Jefferson Airplane Takes Off. But the record company did some censoring on some songs, and he actually pulled this song completely off the album due to some of the lyric. So that's cool to have that. I found that in Salvation Army years ago, 20 cents. And I got some really good things out of that store. And then I remember one day Salvation Army decided to stop selling records around here. So that was a bummer. Here's Jefferson Air. Oh, I forgot to tell you. This is the first variant of the sleeve with the outer seam. That was for 1966 only. And then for 67, they did the inner seams. And this is a promo for Somebody to Love on both sides, March of 67. And then the third variation is this one. And it's got the outer seams. And it's got identification numbers here at the base. So that tells you it's from around 1968. Just before they went to the psychedelic sleeve in 69. So even though this is the orange label, they were still using the older company sleeves, if it didn't have a picture sleeve, which this one did. And this is a really cool lather picture sleeve that half of Mouse and Kelly did. Kelly did it. I think his first name was Anton Kelly. He did a lot of the San Francisco psychedelic posters, along with Mouse. So pretty cool. I always thought that reminded me of a little bit of Mushrooms, but I guess you have to be tripping to see it. So very cool, Crown of Creation on a float. Okay, we've been listening to since we opened with some Balin. And we close with some Airplane. We've been listening to some rare Jefferson Airplane. And this is a bootleg CD that I got in 94. And it's outtakes from the box set that came out, plus some live stuff. So we're listening to the Saga of Sydney Space Pig right now. Three different parts. And earlier we heard a really long version of Pretty As You Feel. Okay, that does it for the video, and I thought I'd try something new with some lighting, and I got my camera on Color Pop, so everything looks more colorful. So throw a little flavor into the mix, and it looks like there's gonna be a part four of this series. I think I can scrape together another video. So be looking for that in the future, and probably my next video will be recent finds. So until then, guys, take care and have a good one. Bye.